Hello everyone, this is Pete and Shauna with Golly Family Discipleship. It is a winter evening and we're on our back porch outside attempting to do this vlog. And like Shauna says, we're both wearing shorts, so it's a very nice day. Today we begin 1 Corinthians chapter 8, and Shauna's going to start by reading the first three verses of that chapter.
It says, "Now about food sacrificed to idols, we know that we all possess knowledge, but knowledge puffs up while love builds up. Those who think they know something do not yet know as they ought to know, but whoever loves God is known by God."
So the basic theme of this is love over knowledge.
Yeah.
That we need to be loving each other. One of the things that, when you read today's blog, that I attributed it to is me and Shauna like to do woodworking. And one of my favorite tools whenever I'm building something is my drill and driver, because it makes strong joints. I like to use a screw instead of a nail. It's easier on my shoulder, which bothers me when I use a hammer. But let's just say I want to join some boards together with a nail. Do I use my drill to beat the nail in, Shauna?
No.
No, it'd be the right tool, but using it in the wrong way, right? I need to have a hammer for that. And one of the things that we need to realize as Christians is sometimes we can have knowledge, we can have wisdom, and we use it in the wrong way because we simply don't use it with love.
That's absolutely right. It actually causes a lot of rejection or misunderstanding. Even though you may have the knowledge, the way that it is given, when given without love or without sacrifice.
Or in anger,
right, if it's given in anger, it's not going to be well received, and it's going to be misinterpreted. So when we accompany knowledge with love, we have a greater opportunity to minister to someone or to draw someone into the knowledge that we have, and that is the knowledge of the saving power of Jesus Christ.
I've known people use scripture to hurt people, to try to hurt their feelings or to say something about them. There's individuals who use scripture out of anger, and you hear them, they shout and they stand on the street corner and they say, "Hey," at the top of their lungs, "you're going to die and go to hell if you don't accept Jesus," which is true. It is absolutely true that if you leave this world not knowing Jesus Christ, you're going to die and go to hell. But wouldn't it be more effective to show them the love of Jesus Christ, to lead them to Jesus by showing them the love of Christ? And then that way you're using love and knowledge.
Absolutely. It's hard to get it right all the time, but simply being a vessel that delivers the love of Christ is phenomenal. It is chain breaking. It is redeeming.
Mm-hmm.
It's what we should do. We should be the hands and feet of Christ, but we have to be loving in order to do that. And we need to have the knowledge, and we need to have the wisdom, and ask God to help us deliver that in the way that is fitting to Him and for His kingdom.
Because our ultimate goal as Christians is to lead others to Christ. You know, the Great Commission in Matthew chapter 28 says, "Go ye into all the world, making disciples." So our goal is to lead others into a relationship with Jesus Christ, and it has to be done with love. It's the way Jesus did it. I had a conversation with a man at work today, and one of the things we talked about is the nails did not hold Jesus to that cross.
Right.
His love for us held Him to that cross, and we need to show that same love to this world around us.
I remember as a young child being terrified when I would return home from my grandma's house, because my grandma always used her knowledge of the Bible, but not necessarily in the way of love, but in the way of fear. I was afraid. There was no way, the way that she explained things, there was no way I was going to ever live up to what she was saying was the gospel. So it was being used in the wrong way. But I grew up and I studied for myself, and I understood what the love of Christ can do.
So going forward this week, make sure you read this chapter every day. Read chapter 8 every day in your family. Discuss it. Talk with it about people at work. Talk with it around the dinner table.
Yeah.
But get in deep into this world at Word and get an understanding of what's going on. And as we go forward this week, as always, we want to encourage you to encounter God every day.
Yeah.
Exalt God every day. Put on some praise and worship music. Spend some time just giving Him the honor and glory that He is due. Edify yourself. Read that Word. Study it. Talk about it. And then finally, engage this world. Make disciples. Lead others to Jesus Christ.
Absolutely. And until tomorrow, may God bless you.
God bless.